Okay, now you can hear. Before we open with prayer, I'm going to read a few verses from the Apostle Paul's letter to the Colossians. And let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to the which also ye are called in one body, and be ye thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. And whatsoever ye do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God and the Father by him. Amen. Throughout the ages, the children of God have been a singing people. We read in the Old Testament the time of the temple. There were the Levites whose main purpose and vocation was to lead in the singing of the psalms. And most of the psalms, of course, were written to be sung also. In the New Testament time, the time of Jesus even, remember how it was with Jesus on the night in which he was betrayed. See, celebrated the Passover with his disciples and instituted the Lord's Supper. It says they sung a hymn, and then they went out. They went out to the Garden of Gethsemane where Jesus would remember us even in his prayer. The Apostle Paul wrote unto the Corinthians as well as unto the Colossians concerning the singing and the beauty of it, the gift that God has given us as his children to be a singing people. We go forward in time to the time of the Reformation, and the Lutherans at that time, under the inspiration or the leading of Martin Luther himself, they became known as the singing people. And I think that has trickled down into even the Lestadian movement, as we are a people who are very involved in singing. I want to read something for you. And you have not come to hear me this evening, but yet I think it is fitting. Martin Luther wrote, "That it is good and pleasing to God to sing spiritual songs is, I think, not hidden to any Christian. Everyone is acquainted not only with the example of the kings and prophets of the Old Testament, who praised God with singing and playing, with poetry and all kinds of string music, but also with the common use of music, especially the singing of psalms, in Christendom from the very beginning. St. Paul, too, instituted this in 1 Corinthians 14:15 and bids the Colossians, chapter 3, 16, which we read, heartily to sing spiritual songs and psalms unto the Lord, in order that thereby God's word and Christian doctrine might be used and practiced in divers ways. I greatly desire that youth, which after all should and must be trained in music and other proper arts, might have something whereby it might be weaned from the love ballads, and instead of these, learn something beneficial, and take up the good with relish as befits youth. Nor am I at all of the opinion that all the arts are to be overthrown and cast aside by the gospel, as some super spiritual people protest. But I would gladly see that all the arts, especially music, in the service of him who has given and created them." Shall we turn to the Father in a moment of prayer? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, amen. Dear good and gracious God, we thank you for the gift of song. We thank you that you have granted us voices and talents, that we may sing praises unto thee for what you have done unto us, or for us, in the person of Jesus Christ, our Lord. And as we gather together tonight to sing, may we lift our hearts heavenward, singing with joy in our hearts for that which has been accomplished in our hearts through the merits of Jesus Christ. And through the gift of song, may we teach others that the songs that we sing, the hymns that we sing, would always have a teaching element, that the gospel of Jesus Christ would be first and foremost, even in the gift of song. We thank you that you have brought us here this evening. We thank you for our brother Markus, who has
has been answered the call to play this evening. We pray that you would bless the time that we spend together in fellowship one with another. Hear us now, dear Father, as you told or taught your disciples, saying, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you. Well, as we close this evening, Pastor Phil mentioned that God's people have always been singing people. And I have to acknowledge our family was a singing family. And we love to sing. But I have to admit this, that Nora, you weren't even close when it comes to an organist. So. But anyhow, so thank you, Markus, again. The psalmist writes, sing unto the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm has gotten him the victory. Now let us turn in prayer as we close this evening. Dear Heavenly Father, as we close this evening, we want to thank you for the gift of music. We want to thank you for the gift of songs and hymns and spiritual songs. We want to thank you for this hour that we have been able to gather here and sing of the wondrous things you have done, of your great creation, of the marvelous and wondrous work of salvation, of your love made known to us in your Son, Jesus Christ, as he wrought on the center cross of Calvary our redemption. We thank you for the gift of song and music that we are able to sing of the hope that we have as your children of life eternal, and to sing of the peace that you have given us by faith, that we can rest knowing that our future is secure in the redemptive work of Jesus Christ. So, dear Father, we again thank you for this hour and for the promises in your word which we have just sung. Now may the Lord bless thee and keep thee. May the Lord make his face shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give thee peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And we will sing one more hymn, 458, and then we have refreshments downstairs for everyone.